First of all, I will like to give a huge shout out to my new subscribers, World of Glories, Arjinder Tejwani, Zona Quartz, and thanks to Mohammed Kasim, Vincent Van Langin, and Tamur Virk and Eraser for commenting on my videos. Hello, so this is the website that I created in the last video. So if you want to create a website like this, you can watch that video. So I will provide the link of the video in the description of the video as well. So here, when I finalized the website and when I tried to fill out this form and I click on the button, so I saw this error. So this error occur when you create a form using any plugin and then there is some issue in the server. So then this error occur on your website. So in this video we will see how to fix this error. So I have opened the Elementor editor and I have created this form using Elementor. So I will tell you how to fix it, but you can fix it with the same procedure if you are using any other form plugin. So here, let's try to create a form. So this is just a random form, and when we go to actions after submit, and here we see collected submission and email, because we want to receive an email when this form is submitted. So here when we go to email, we see everything is perfect. So and we update it, and we can now go back to the page. So now if we try to fill the form, so here you see the same error again. So this is the server error. So for this we will need to set up SMTP server. So I will show you that completely in the video. So for this you will need to go to your web hosting. So I am using SambleHost. So I will go to that and I will log in. So I will tell you the procedure from cPanel. So you can just log into your cPanel account and then everything is same in cPanel. cPanel is same in like all of the hostings. So you can log into your cPanel. So here you will need to create an email account. So for that you can search for email. So here you see email accounts, so you have to click on that. And here you will have to create an email for your website. So you will click on create and here select the domain. So I was working on kashifmehmood.com, so I will select that and here write the username. So if you want to create an email, like, let me show you. So if you want to create an email like info@ your domain name .com or whatever it is. So if you want to create add info before your email, so then you can just write info over here. And if you want to use any other like your name or contact@ or something like that, then you can just write that over here. So this will be your professional business email. So if you want, you can connect that to your Gmail as well, that I will show in the end. So here you will have to write the password for your email. So just write a strong password and save it in any file. So I have write a strong password and I will click on edit setting, and here you can give any space to your email. So I will just give it 256 MB of space and I will click on create. So now my email is created here, you can see. And when if I want to send email to this one, then I can also send that and I will be able to receive and check emails over here. here you will have to click on open. So here you can see a configuration message as well. So this is a configuration message that we currently don't need. So we will now go to our website and we will have to log into the dashboard. And now we will have to install a new plugin. So we will have to write SMTP. So we will install this very first plugin. Activate. Let's get started. And here you have to scroll down and click on other SMTP. Save and continue. So here you will have to write your domain name. So I will write mine. So here is the port number. So now here you will have to write the SMTP username. So here you can write your email that you just created. So I will just copy the email. And I will paste it over here. And then I will have to write the password that I settled while creating the email. So I have written the password and now here you have to write the email again. Save and continue. Scroll down, you can save it and you can click on save and continue again. So here you can write any of your personal email. Or maybe the same one. So you can click on save and continue. Skip this setup. So here we have successfully set up our WP mails SMTP. And now we will click on send a test email. And here you can write any of your email to receive a test email. So you can confirm if it's working or not. So I will click on send email. So here you can see the email is sent and now if I go to the email account. So here you can see I have received the test email successfully. So now I will go to the website. And now I will fill the form again. So you can see it is sent successfully. And this one is now working as well. So that's how you can set up SMTP server and fix this error. And if you want to connect the email that you just created with your Gmail, so you will receive all of the emails on your Gmail, then you can watch this video. I will provide the link of the video in the description of the video. So thank you for watching. See you next time.